Welcome to Analytics with Nags.
In this video, we're going to see about how to create a table using a DAX and SSAS Tabular Model, or whether if you're looking for how to create a calculated table in SSAS Tabular Model, and this is the video for you. Basically, either it can be a measure or a calculated column, you need to use DAX. Similarly, in order to create a table, that user-defined table, then you need to use DAX as well. Let's see in this video. If you're new to this channel, hit the subscribe button right now to learn the concepts in SSAS Tabular Model. Let's jump into a demo. We are having this Tabular Model that you are familiar with. Like we have built a model from SSAS Analyst Service AdventureWorks, where you can see a fact table is connected with different dimension tables. Now, in order to create a model here, you need to go to the tabular view. Then there are different ways to create, and one of the easiest ways, like you assume you want to duplicate this dim product. Okay, so what you need to do, click on this icon, one over here, right over here, whatever you are seeing here. So this will create a calculated table. So I just want to duplicate the dim product, so just put dim product over here. Then what will happen, just it. So it will duplicate the same column here. I will rename it as duplicate product. Okay, so this will be useful when you have some kind of disconnected dimension you want to create and you want to manipulate it. Let's see how it looks like. So here this is the dim product that is connected. Whatever you created here, that will be disconnected. So you are duplicating this product, dim product, okay, over here, duplicate of product. This is simple way of creating it. So this doesn't involve much of DAX. Let us try to create a calculated table using sales territory. So in this, I want these two columns to be a separate table, like distinct values of these two columns, like country and group. How to do it? So let's see. Right, one more table, click on that plus icon. So that will create, I will say, country and group. Okay, let us rename it later. Now try to type the formula. The formula is summarize. I mean, there are different ways to create. I want to go for this. So summarize the table name. Table name is dim sales territory, comma. You need to mention those two column names. One is country, another thing is group. So this basically use the group by operation. Let's try to view this code, the summarize, and you can see here the formula here. The summarize of this table, these two has created one of two columns. So here I can rename it as country. Here you can click on it or rename it. Let me rename it here. It's okay. Here, once you click enter, then only there is an issue with working on it. That's absolutely fine. So after pressing enter, it will create calculated table one. Then here you can rename it as country region. So this has created a table. So this table persistent, I mean, this will be stored actually. Okay, it's like another table. Now you can see here from the sales territory, there are 11 records, and the combination of these two gives you totally there are multiple records, right? I mean 7 records. So country region over here, so this contains 7 records. So this is what a calculated table is, which is nothing but creating a derived table in SSAS using DAX. So another table has created here. You can see the country region here that is not connected. If there is some relationship you need to make, you obviously can go and make it. I hope you guys like this video. If you like this, hit the subscribe button if you haven't subscribed yet, and comment below for your queries. Do remember that data is your asset.